Redrock Study. For the Redrock Study, like for the ecosystem game and the other games previously used, McKinsey decided to stick to the ecology theme of the PSG. You are sent to Redrock Island, again in a caretaker role, to this time control certain wildlife populations or alternatively to preserve the island's flora biodiversity. It is kind of funny. In the ecosystem game, you are made to choose a location for a coral reef ecosystem, while in truth, as a consultant, you are more likely to choose a suitable location for a deep water oil drilling platform. Well, just feeding the stereotypes here, of course. And now, in the second game, you play the role of a forest ranger. You could start assuming you are applying to the World Wildlife Fund, but no. These games are dealt to you by the world's largest management consulting firm, McKinsey and Company. Behind the facade of this ecological gibberish, and I am saying this as somebody who holds a PhD on the economics of climate change, you will find that actually, with the Redrock Study, McKinsey has gone back to the roots. The Redrock Study is a heavily quant-focused assessment with lots of data and trap questions, just like the PSG's predecessor, the McKinsey PST, the problem-solving test. As I will demonstrate to you in my next video of this McKinsey Solve Game playlist, you can actually make use of McKinsey's former problem-solving mock tests to prepare for the Redrock Study. For this, I invite you to download my free consulting online test prep kit where I show you how to get those. If you want to practice the Redrock Study and pass the McKinsey Solve test safely, you may also want to check out a professional McKinsey Solve prep kit offered by a third-party provider, which you only need to pay for if you pass the test. The links to my free online test prep kit as well as the professional Solve prep kit you'll find in the video description below this video. I think at least by its outline, the Redrock Study does a good job of resembling the phases of a typical consulting project. The Redrock Study in its present form comes in two parts. The first part is split into three phases, namely the investigation, analysis and report phases. In the investigation phase, you will be familiarized with the games or project's objective and be presented with data to screen and select from. In the analysis phase, you need to process the data and run your computations, and in the report phase, just like a management consultant, you need to synthesize your results in an executive summary and present them graphically. In the second part of the game, which actually much more feels like a test, you need to solve a series of mini case questions. These questions are still themed, but are not anymore mathematically interlinked, neither with the part 1 data nor with each other. Like for the ecosystem game, you are endowed with 35 minutes to go through the Redrock Study, and I tell you already now, this will feel very short, so time management is key. At least you can take a breath between the phases when you can enjoy the untimed tutorials. Let us go through the four components of the Redrock Study, starting with the investigation phase. In the investigation phase, your screen will be composed of three main elements. On the left, you will find a menu displaying in which phase or part of a Redrock Study you currently are. In the main part of your screen, you will find a short introduction to the background of the assignment, followed by your objective and a rather long series of data charts and so on. On the right, you will find your research journal, which will accompany you during all three phases of the first part of the Redrock Study. I have prepared a little example for you to give you a better idea of what to expect. Your job during the investigation phase is to collect such information in your research journal that may be required to compute if a study objective can be met. Information presented in white boxes you can drag over to your research journal and drop there. So let us look through this example. The background story. You are a forest ranger and were dispatched to Redrock Island to study the intricate relationship of its flora and fauna and help preserve it. Fine. Objective: bears consume honey. Your task is to ensure that in 5 years from now, bees produce enough honey so that the bear population will have doubled. Now, the study objective is something you always want to drag into your research journal. And bears? Time to change my theme again. Next piece, a chart showing how the number of bee colonies on Redrock Island has evolved over time. Now, this looks relevant, but you might need to check if you need to collect the stats for all years or just the last year. Going on, every year, 2 square kilometers of forest are lost due to urban construction works. Okay, this will affect the number of bee populations to be collected. Hunters shoot 20 bears per year. Wait, what? That sounds brutal as well as relevant. The local council is worried about two new diseases that could infect the bee colonies. This sentence contains a number, but without further context, it would seem anecdotal. I would not collect this piece of information. Redrock Island has many forests. In 1 square kilometer of forest, typically 25 bee colonies live. That surely you need for some equation. Bears like to dance in the moonlight. Maybe not relevant. In the real example, you have to scroll down further to scan the long list of information and data points given. After you have added information to your research journal, you can relabel them, resort them, and even add a priority badge to an important piece of information. Unfortunately, a research journal is a little fiddly, but meh. Note that during the investigation phase, you do not have to compute anything yet, but you have to consider which pieces of information will be required to run the calculations for answering the questions around the study objective. Do not collect all information randomly though, as the game most probably measures your capability to discern important information from a relevant one. The sorting and prioritizing of the information may also have an impact on your process score, but then, given the scarce time available, I would suggest to focus on ensuring you collect what is needed and to then move on. If you realize in the next phase you have forgotten to collect some data, the game currently seems to allow you to go back to the investigation phase. Of course, this costs you extra time. The analysis phase. In the analysis phase, you will be posed with 3 to 4 sets of questions that might build on each other and for which you need to leverage the data you have collected. They are directly or loosely connected to the study objective. So, as an example set of questions you may find, if the reforestation initiatives currently considered do not go ahead, what are the expected number of bears and bee colonies on the western shores of Redrock Island at the end of year 5? To derive the answers, you need to use a fiddly calculator appearing on your screen. You need to drag the data collected in your research journal and drop it into the calculator. Then you can run some mathematical operations and drag the result from your calculator into the blanks. Oh, what result is this? Guys, if you have watched this video until here, you would indeed honor me with your like and subscription. Thank you. Please note that it makes sense to use the in-game calculator, because again, McKinsey surely wants to see a protocol of how you derived your answers. You will also need to save the results you have generated in your research journal for the next phase. Of course though, you are free to build the equations you need to solve on your scratch paper and to double check your calculations with a real or analog calculator. You will need quite some time to run the calculations, whereas the final phase of the first part of a Redrock study will feel comparatively short. The report phase. In the report phase, you will need to fill the blanks of an executive summary in which you more or less rehash the findings from your analysis phase. So if you have done your job well so far, you can now harvest your fruits and drag your results from a research journal into the blanks. From now till year 5, the number of bee populations will have grown by X percent per year. The share of bee populations on the eastern shores of Redrock Island will amount to X percent of all bee populations on Redrock Island. And at the end of year 5, X bears will dance in the moonlight? Okay, maybe that piece of information was relevant after all. You will probably also be asked to visualize your results by selecting a suitable chart. I do not go deep into presentation skills in this video, but a bar chart usually is the best choice if you want to display some sort of frequency or compare between competing variables, maybe over time as well. A line chart is often used when you want to track the development of a single variable over time. A pie chart is ideal to display the relative share of a variable in some overall total. This will mark the end of the first part of a Redrock study, and you will be moved to the second part, the cases. In the second part of the study, you will face 6 to 10 mini cases. They will still be loosely connected to the theme of the first part of a Redrock study, but mathematically they are not anymore interconnected, neither to each other nor to the first part's data. These questions again are mostly quant questions, where you need to fill in numbers or select from multiple choice options. You will be presented with graphs, tables, text questions, you name it. After you have made it to this part of the video, you will probably expect to see some example questions. For didactic reasons, I refrain from presenting you an example question here. I have much better to offer in the next video. Note that the first part of a Redrock study is complex and mean, while the second part appears more digestible. However, the main enemy during the Redrock study is time. You probably just will not have enough time to answer everything, so you need to make sure you at least get to the cases part. So while you try to crack the first part of the study, like in your good old school exams, make sure you do not get hung up for too long so that you still have time for the later questions in your test. Redrock study. Interactive practice questions.